Just 6 days before John Cena and Randy Orton collided at No Mercy 2007 for Cena's WWE Championship, a torn pectoral muscle forced Cena to vacate the title. At No Mercy, Mr. McMahon awarded the vacated championship to Orton, but Triple H stepped in, setting up an impromptu title match, which he won. The Game then successfully defended the title against Umaga, but Orton invoked his rematch clause for later in the night and recaptured the championship in a last man standing match against the Cerebral Assassin. Before the battle for control of Raw at the Survivor Series 2003 event, co-general manager Eric Bischoff granted Chris Jericho an opportunity to challenge for the Intercontinental Championship, and he made sure the Ayatollah of Rock and Rolla captured the title for the sixth time. Co-general manager Stone Cold Steve Austin couldn't overturn the decision, so he granted RVD an immediate rematch inside a steel cage. It came down to a photo finish, but RVD kicked the door into Jericho, allowing his feet to hit the floor first. With John Cena gearing up for a showdown against The Miz at WrestleMania 27, the anonymous Raw general manager forced them to team up to challenge the Core for the WWE Tag Team Championship. Even Cena was stunned after Miz dropped Justin Gabriel with a skull-crushing finale to win the titles, but Wade Barry immediately invoked the Core's rematch clause. Cena and Miz were moments away from retaining the titles, but the A-lister betrayed his WrestleMania opponent, allowing Pete Slater to steal the victory and reclaim the championships. The Money in the Bank contract is so exciting because it allows the holder to cash in whenever he or she wants to, leading to some very short title reigns. The first 4 years of cash-ins were sudden, but they didn't immediately follow a title change. The first time that happened came in Extreme Rules 2009 when Jeff Hardy bested Edge for the WWE Championship, but was then the target of a cash-in by CM Punk, who defeated the charismatic Enigma to win the title. Since then, we've seen it happen four more times: WWE TLC 2011, SummerSlam 2013, Survivor Series 2015, and WWE Money in the Bank 2016. It's one thing to win a title, but it's another to hold on to it. Make sure to catch WWE Clash of Champions this Sunday to see which champions hold on to their titles. Until next time, thanks for watching List This.